Stargazing, exploring the night sky. It's an activity anyone can enjoy. Just step outside on a clear, dark evening, a couple of hours after sunset. Then, look up. You'll see the stars of winter scattered across the sky. The trick to finding your way around the sky is to look for some easy-to-recognize star patterns called constellations. To make these patterns, draw imaginary lines between the stars, like a celestial game of connect the dots. Even if you live in a big city with lots of light pollution, you can still observe the night sky. The brighter stars will be visible, even through all the glow. Most people know about the Big Dipper, so we'll start there. During the cold winter months, it stands on its end, stretching up from the northern horizon. Here's the handle. And there's the cup. The Big Dipper is actually part of a larger constellation called Ursa Major, the Greater Bear. The Dipper rides on the back of the bear. The two end stars of the cup are named Mirac and Dubby. They're also called the pointers because they point the way to Polaris, the North Star. Draw a line from Mirac to Dubby and extend it out to Polaris. When you look at Polaris, you're looking north. Now you know your directions.
Under a dark country sky, you can see thousands more stars. Look high in the sky to find Vega in the constellation Lyra, the Harp. Now that we've found Vega again, we're in summer triangle territory. Remember Deneb? It's the top star in the Northern Cross, which is also part of a lovely constellation called Cygnus the Swan. South of Cygnus is another bird, Aquila the Eagle. It's home to Altair, the third star in the summer triangle. The more you look at the night sky, the more you'll find. And all you have to do is go outside and look up. Try it tonight.